military contractors funding the Ground Zero Mosque.
I'm not saying you can't do it.
I know.
Go ahead and do it.
You can't say that. It's my right to do it.
Right. We'll keep it respectful. We'll keep it respectful, sir. Thank you.
We've got defense contractors, which are funding this grant. So defense contractors are supposed to be subcontracting from the American government, right, to protect. Protect us from random person, but why the hell are they funding the mosques? Yeah, so you've got, this is the line here. You've got the Imam, and this is the Cordoba Initiative, which is building the mosque. That's the organization.
He's just getting started, if you want to say.
Okay. Leslie Deke is one of the main guys. He provides the operation budget for the Cordoba Initiative. Leslie Deke is also a principal in Patriot Defense Group LLC. He's a military contractor. This is his board. You've got James Davids, former CIA Deputy Director of Ops. He was the head of operational response to 9/11. You've got General Byron Brown, U.S. Special Ops Commander on the War on Terror. And you've got Alex Capello, who's an investment banker, but he sits on he's the director of Mideast Policy at Durant Corporation, which is another military contractor. Now, why would these guys be funded? The mines. Okay? Now, it goes even deeper. Leslie Deke's father, Nicholas Deke, was the top OSS commander. Now, if you're not aware, the OSS is the precursor to the CIA. Okay? He starts a company called Deke Pereira. It's a foreign exchange broker who, I believe it was Reagan, or it might have been Bush Sr., broke them up in the 80s because they were laundering drug cartel money. They then rebranded as Goldline International. Now, if you watch Fox News, you'll recognize that name because they are the main sponsor of the Glenn Beck Show and also other Fox News shows. So Fox News is a subsidiary of News Corp, which the major, the second largest shareholder is Prince Alawid bin Talal, who's also funding the Cordoba Initiative. Now you can connect him. He's a part of the royal, Saudi royal family, right? Now the Saudi royal family and the bin Ladens are very intimately connected, and they're co-investors with the Bush family in the Carlyle Group, a third military contractor. Now, you've got the Carlyle Group, the Bush family. Karen Hughes was a part of the Bush administration. She's the one who introduced the Imam to the FBI and became a consultant for the FBI. He also sits on the Council on Foreign Relations, the Religious Advisory Board, with which Rupert Murdoch is also a member of the CFR. Rockefeller, Carnegie, and Ford are also members of the CFR. And they're funding the American Society for Muslim Advancement, who the Imam is also the chairman on that. He's the chairman of that organization.
Holy Lucky.
Now, Carlyle Group connection to Frank Carlucci, who's a former Secretary of Defense, former Secretary of the CIA. He's involved in the National War College, he's involved in the CIA. Leslie Deke is also involved with National Defense University Foundation and the National War College, which is funded by Boeing, Lockheed Martin, Raytheon, and Northrop Grumman.
No surprise.
Right? Who subcontracts from the Pentagon. So that finishes up that. Now, the State Department has the Imam as an ambassador to Islamic cultures across the world. So what happened to separation of church and state? Why are we sending emissaries as ambassadors to other religious groups? I don't know. But so he's also working for the U.S. State Department. So there's a connection there, which obviously is connected to the FBI, CIA, and Pentagon.